Welcome back to my channel, Mend with Mare. Thank you all for the love, the comments, the sharing about the song Bigger Than the Whole Sky. I do want to clarify something very quickly. Every single song of any artist is open to your own interpretation. And I'm sorry if it came across as me telling you, yes, this is about loss around pregnancy, infertility, miscarriage. That wasn't what I was trying to say. I was trying to emphasize the fact that this group of people that have experienced this type of loss, the conversation around their loss is overlooked so often and not taken as seriously. And so I was very passionate about making sure that there was a light shed on this group of wonderful people that have dealt with so much. I also wanted to say that you all are so strong. This is a channel that I created for mending and exploring and connecting and healing. I hope that you all have found some type of solace in each other through the comments and knowing that you're not alone. Thank you to everybody who has shared. And because of the response to that song about loss, I felt as if I should react, analyze the song Marjorie, which is one of my favorite songs ever. I will say with Marjorie, I have heard the song a million gazillion times. Sometimes I feel like it comes on as a sign, like my grandfather speaking to me. It means so, so much. And just to give a little bit of backstory, Taylor Swift's grandmother's name was Marjorie. And she was actually an aspiring singer. I think she became somewhat prominent as a singer in Puerto Rico. And she gave it all up to be a wife and a mother. I will point out some of the references that Taylor makes to her and to that. And I feel as if this is just a beautiful way of honoring your ancestors or honoring any person that left a big imprint on your life. So let's go ahead and get right on into it.
Never be so kind, you forget to be clever.
When I hear those lyrics really quickly, I think that sometimes I have said on here, like, you don't want to be too kind because your kindness can be used or seen as your weakness, and then that opens you up to being taken advantage of. So I like this because it's like, never be too kind, you forget to be clever. Clever in the sense of, you know, looking out for yourself or putting dots together, noticing things that you should, but never be too clever or looking into something more that you forget to be kind. It's so pretty. I love it.
And if I didn't know better, I think you were talking to me now. If I didn't know better, I think you were still around. What died didn't stay dead. What died didn't stay dead.
That we always have to remember that no matter what your beliefs are, your religious or spiritual beliefs, one thing that is true is that when something dies, even if you believe that when you die, it's dead and gone, everything is, it's not, because you live on in people's memories. You show up in their memories and when they talk about you. And for those of you that believe in more than that, you know that they still are very much alive and looking out for you or with you in some ways. And sometimes, you know, we want to go looking for that validation, and sometimes it's there, sometimes it's not. But honestly, I mean, the research does show that people that have some type of spiritual life do live longer. So I'm always like, hey, believe whatever you want to believe. If it gives you peace and joy, go for it, as long as it's not harming other people. But I think that Taylor's letting us know something here. She's like, if I didn't know better, I'd think you were still around. And I'm sure some of you might have had that feeling where a certain song comes on. There are times, I swear, that my dog will have the smell of wood and gasoline. My grandfather was a carpenter, among other things. Even my next door neighbor, he remodels houses and he creates his own furniture and installation and electric type of things. And anytime I walk into his workshop, it's like I just get flooded with that overwhelming feeling. And it might just be the smell of it takes me back to that point in time in my life. But that's so beautiful because that makes me feel connected to my grandfather in that moment. So I think that there's something for Taylor that gives her that little feeling, that little nudge, like maybe we don't know everything. Maybe she's still around. Because she's saying, if I didn't know better, and that it didn't die, it stayed alive. It's alive in my head. You didn't go away because you're truly alive in the memory and in your mind and hearing that person or in your heart. It's really, really beautiful.
Now be so polite, you forget your power.
Never be so polite that you forget your power. It kind of reminds me of the first verse, like never be so kind and generous to someone else that you forget your own power. And it's kind of like, to me, you all might interpret this differently, but to me, with my life, it makes me think of the fact that it is important to be polite. However, there's a line where you do not do it at the detriment to yourself and to your own well-being. And so it's saying, you know, be polite, but don't forget your power. And then never wield such power that you don't treat people as human beings. As big as you get, you always want to treat people like that you're no better than them, even if you happen to have a lot of power in some ways, or ways that we observe as power in our society, even though we all have our own power, truly. It's a really good sentiment. Like, no matter how big you get, you still want to be humble. You still want to be polite. You still want to remember that your shit stinks.
And if I didn't know better, I think you were listening to me now.
So she changed it up a little bit here. She said, if I didn't know better, I'd think you were listening to me now. And in the beginning, she said, I think you were talking to me now. So it sounds as if they almost can communicate with each other, even though they're not physically together. And then saying like, if I didn't know better, I'd still think you were around here. Like, that's how real it feels. The connection that she had with her grandmother. It's crazy. That regret of not knowing how long you had with the person and taking it for granted. She's talking about the fact that she would complain about going to her grandma. She complained the whole ride there and up the stairs, and that they used to do frozen swims together. And it sounds like autumn time. And she said, you always go past where our feet could touch. So it's showing that she was little, that her and her brother were really little when they would go and spend time with her grandmother. And just that feeling, and I have it too, with people that have passed away in my life, and especially my grandfather, that I wish I would have had a moment to sit down with him and listen to all of his unique sayings, which I still remember, but just to really ask him how to be and how to handle things. You know, when you lose a grandparent or you lose someone when you're young, you unfortunately don't have perspective. You don't have an understanding of time and how limited it is. And you maybe aren't aware of that person. You don't see them as the whole, complete, complex person that they are, because you just know them as a grandparent, you know, having to go spend time with an older person instead of this person that's got so much wisdom and a life that was lived, and just that they have so many things to tell you and to learn from them, and that their blood is running through your veins, you know, and interpret this however you want. But that's how I look at it. Like, so much of what they've worked hard for and who that they've been, that you are actually a direct result of that. And I find that really beautiful and comforting.
Asked you to write it down for me. Should have kept every grocery store receipt, because every scrap of you would be taken.
Didn't think I was gonna get emotional. Why? It's okay. It's okay. Tears are good. Tears are positive. So she's having that regret. She's like, oh my God, if I would have known, I would have kept everything of yours, everything that I could ever get my hands on, and every scrap was taken from her. She's like, if I could even just kept the grocery store receipt and watching her sign her name Marjorie. It's just, it's so beautiful. It's so beautiful. It's so beautiful. I do think of, unfortunately, I, you know, didn't want it to happen, but with my grandparents, there, you know, was a decision made to do an auction, and I didn't have the opportunity to get really any of my grandfather's things. And I know that being upset about that doesn't do me any good, but I do wish that I understand where, like, every scrap of you would be taken from me. And even the other day, my mother had his recliner that he sat in. She's like, oh, it doesn't work anymore. We're gonna have to get rid of it. And I totally freaked out. And I was like, you have to keep a part of that fabric for me at least. And she's like, Meredith, you have to let go. You know, she's like telling me these things. And I'm like, I'm not asking for the whole chair. I'm asking for like a little scrap, like a little square of the fabric. Luckily she got, my mom just brought me the actual armrest that goes to chair. And she's like, well, when you do gardening, you can put your knees on the armrest. And I was like, perfect, perfect. I can have a little part of my grandfather with me. In all actuality, he's always with me. His memory lives on in me. And sometimes I do feel like I hear him in my own ways. I feel you, Taylor. I totally understand what that's like. So she says, all your closets of backlog dreams and how you left them all to me. So look, her grandmother wanted to be a singer. She was a singer. She was an opera singer. That's right. And she's actually singing on this track at different parts. I watched an interview of Taylor with Zane Lowe, and she was explaining that her mother found some of her old music, and so they put some of it on this track of her grandmother. Her grandmother's actually singing with her. So if you think about that, you know, all of her backlog dreams and how you left them all to me, it's like Taylor inherited all of those dreams that her grandmother had. And I think that she probably wishes she could talk to her about maybe why she walked away from her dreams, why she put having a family first, or all of the things that you wish when you're older you knew about your grandparent, but yet you can't grasp the importance of them at that time. Can't stand it. So beautiful. It's so beautiful. Again, this can be about anyone. For Taylor, it's her grandmother. The only thing I'll ever say is that all I know is that we don't know. We don't truly know what exists after we die. We don't know. She went from, and if I didn't know better, I'd think you were talking to me now. And then she says, listening to me now. And then she said, I think you were singing to me now. And then you hear her grandmother's opera singing in the background. So she's actually literally singing to her in that moment. She goes, if I didn't didn't know better. I think you were still around. And so it gives me that feeling that like maybe she's like, I know better. Like you're not here. You're not physically here. But I still feel you all around and I know better, but you are still around. And that is just so beautiful. One of the times that I felt like I really related to Taylor was I heard her in an interview say that she'll be woken up in the middle of the night and just like sits down at the piano and starts playing, or just a melody or a lyric comes into her mind as if it's just been downloaded into her. And I feel that I have creative downloads where I am woken up and I am, it's like I have to write it down. And I have had somebody who I went to totally not believing in like mediums necessarily. And I was like, oh, okay, I'm going to go to this person that somebody I knew was raving about. I'm like, let's put them to the test. And one of the things that did come from it was, you know, your grandpa, he's really trying to get you to write. And look, it could be bogus. That could be completely made up. But when I picked up the pen and paper and started writing, it helped me through a really hard time. So even if it wasn't real, even if it was totally bogus, just the idea that my grandfather might want me to do that, just no matter what it was, I still wrote. And as I started writing more and more of my book, weird things that I hadn't even remembered of like short stories from middle school, my cousin's wife gave to my mom. And I was like, what? I don't even remember even writing these and doing these crazy drawings. And then my mom, one day I was feeling really, really, really down with some of the circumstances that I was going through in my life. And my mom sent me a picture of this drawing that I did of my grandfather back in the day. And look, that could have totally been coincidence that my mom just happened to have come across that picture that I drew of my grandfather and just happened to send it to me in that moment. But it was bizarre because a wave came over me of peace and comfort and remembering like, yeah, I adored him as much as I do now. So I love you, Grandpa. And I'm sending love to you all. And I hope that this song makes you think of things that come up for you around people that you love, that you've lost, and know that you're not alone and that we're here for each other. All right. So it's such a beautiful and comforting song to me. And I hope you found it that way as well. All right. Have a good, beautiful, wonderful day. Please like and subscribe and send it to your friends. Thank you so much. Mwah.